coming. These boys created this fantastic song. The song's called The Swansea Way. It features lyrics about Alan Curtis and Federico Fernandez, who are here today as well.
Sign of Success is a 10-week employability course, and we work on improving confidence and removing any barriers people may have to the workplace. 16 to 25 year olds is the age group we're working with. Some people may have left college, some are on job seekers allowance, maybe signing on, so that's where we try and support them and give them as many opportunities as we can to find employment. Today we've got Learn Through Music in. They've produced a song which we're going to hopefully show today and showcase the voices, so hopefully it'll be a good day.
I was in a college course and I wasn't really sure what I wanted to do, like, after the course finished, so I thought, oh, I weighed up my options and then this opportunity came for me.
I had no job. I've not one job in my life at all, so coming along with this, it was a help to encourage my CV almost, you know, to construct it and, you know, make myself more confident when going to an interview.
It's fair to say not many of them turned up with obvious musical talent.
No, it's true. None of them had any musical background whatsoever. Music can just instill so much confidence and so many other skills, so many employability skills that are so key to people that it's overlooked a lot of the time, and it's great to use music in this way.
I've always like wanted to play, but you know, I've never really had the confidence and thought, oh, no, I've never really wanted to be in front of people playing something, thinking I'm not going to be the best at it, I might be a bit embarrassed. Just having a bit of confidence and just being happy with something you can make.
Have you seen or heard the song yet?
No, it's my first time, so I'm waiting for the guys, but it's a beautiful thing for us.
Are you a singer?
No singer, but I love music, so the club works every day to collect different people to come from Swansea City, so this meeting is very nice for us and for the people.
We play the beautiful game of the Swansea Way. Home of passionate fans that are the 12th man.
What do you think of the finished product?
I am actually a bit proud of it. I'm not trying to brag, but I think it's a decent effort for an amateur.
Can you imagine a day when the whole of the Liberty's perhaps singing it?
Oh, I know it sounds like a bit of a cliche, but it would be a dream come true.
Yeah, I think we're nearly there. Like you say, we're not completely safe, but I think another couple of points, two or three points, I think will see us for sure that we'll be safe. But I think also we've got to look at other targets. There's teams just above us who we could maybe catch. So we want to finish the season strong. It's not been obviously the greatest season for ourselves. It's been very difficult, but I think we want to finish the season strong. We've got especially three home games, very tough games, and Man City, Liverpool and Chelsea to come to Liberty, so it'd be great to get some points against them in front of our own fans. If we're speaking, doing this interview 6 weeks ago or 8 weeks ago, we'd be saying the teams around us, we want to get away from them, but I think in that time we've picked up some good wins, we've kind of clawed our way back up the table, and I think now we need to change. We need to look at the teams above us, see how high we can finish in the league rather than looking behind us. I think we need to look in front, but it's crazy how football can change. Like I say, 6 weeks ago we was worrying about the teams just below us, whereas now looking at the teams above us and seeing if we can catch them. It's been a strange season for me, to be honest with you. The start of the season, you know, I wasn't making squads, I wasn't in the team. Looked like maybe my future was going to be elsewhere. But football's crazy, it can change overnight, and all of a sudden, you know, I played a few games towards the end of Gary Monk's reign, and ever since maybe Alan Curtis and new managers coming, I've played a lot of games, and it's funny how it changes. Like I say, at the beginning of the season I was looking at leaving potentially, and then all of a sudden the last maybe 10 or 12 games I've played regularly, you know, so it's mad. I'm just happy that I've been able to be out there. It's been frustrating at the start of the season to watch the games and be a spectator as such and not be able to help the team, whereas, you know, recently I've been able to get on the pitch and try and help the team, because obviously I've been here a long time. It means a lot to myself, and I wanted to be able to be out on the pitch and try and help the team and try and get results and get us out of this situation. Well, I think we're expecting a very good Chelsea. I know, like you say, they've been disappointing this year from their point of view, being reigning champions and not playing great. But I think, you look through that squad and the quality they've got, obviously top quality players, international players who are always going to be difficult to play against. And you mentioned there the new manager going to come in. So I'm sure, the players will have an eye on that. They know they'll be playing for their future, because that manager will be looking to the players he wants to keep and maybe the players that he wants to move on and replace. So they'll have their eye on that. So they've got some extra motivation in that respect. So, as always against Chelsea, very, very tough game. I know it's not been their greatest season, but again, with the quality they've got in their team, if you're not at it and you're not switched on, they'll definitely punish you. Yeah, I still am. Obviously I'm coming towards the back end of my career. I've played, I've been a professional for maybe 15, 16 years, and I still enjoy being out there every day on the training pitch and putting the white shirt on, being out in the Liberty Stadium or anywhere in the Premier League. I still love it. I mean, you can't not love playing in the Premier League for a team like Swansea, who is obviously close to my heart. So I love every minute of it, whether it's playing on the match day or whether it's training. I'm still enthusiastic and I want to carry on as long as I can, and I feel I'm fit and strong and I can go for a few more years for sure.
For us, because we started back at just before Christmas, and all their work has gone into this evening, and it's just a lovely celebration of everything they've done coming together at the end. So
tonight, what we try and do with all of these enterprise, all the enterprise projects, whether it be a book or a DVD, we always try and bring the whole thing together into a proper launch where all the pupils can really celebrate their achievement. So we can bring people in to see what quality they've produced, and it's just great. It's nice to celebrate that.
I just think they're just so excited that we've been able to hold it at the Liberty Stadium, and they meet in Lee Trundle, present them certificates, and just the experiences they've had, and it's just nice to see it all together at the end, and for them to get recognised for their work. I think it's brilliant.
It's all part, as well as that, of the Swans as a football club being part of the community, and any of us who do anything really need to work within our communities and support our communities, and Pen-Y-Bryn School do a magnificent job looking after the youngsters who study there, and this is an amazing project, and for me it meant going to the school, sitting for an hour, drinking a cup of tea, having biscuits and talking about the Swans. I mean, that's perfect, but it's great to be involved. It's a great project. I'm a great fan of encouraging young people to read, so this is going to put a book into the hands of young people through libraries, and it's going to raise money for Tí Hafan as well, which is an amazing charity. And if all the books sell, which they will do, you can get them in the club shop as well as here tonight. It's going to make a lot of money for Tí Hafan, who care for our young people.
Tí Hafan's been a charity we worked with previously, and I think it's a really important charity. They do fantastic work. And it's just the fact that we're able to help them through one of these projects, raise some money for them, and also raise awareness through the books that we do. It's just fantastic for everybody that way.
Our pupils, all of the pupils in my school, have severe and complex needs. Yet, in spite of that, they are absolutely capable of producing work of outstanding professional quality. And they do.
And the great thing about this football club, it's never forgotten its roots. Its feet are firmly on the floor, and they've kept part of the community. They've not forgotten the community that has made them the success they are today.
When the Swans are marching in, I want to be there in their